Hello, son. You know, he doesn't do nothing anymore. Sits in that room, listens to the tapes. The tapes, which I buy him. You know, you're 18 years old, boy. You listening? 18. You know what I did by the time I was 18? I had already been working 6 years and had been in the service. Yeah, you close the door. You better close the door. You know, don't. Just don't humor me. It's time he grew up. No, it's time he grew up. You know, you just leave it alone. You let the boy go. You let him do whatever he wants to do. He doesn't help out here. Doesn't do nothing here but cause me a headache. And I'm sorry, but I'm tired, honey. You know what? Your son ain't nothing but a worthless dreamer. He's gonna have to come down to reality right now. And I've had it. You will never amount to anything.
Drumming's an easy part. See, I can do this act alone. I often do.
We want people to either love what we're doing or hate what we're doing. Visually speaking, we really take a lot of care and we are really dedicated to bringing to people an art form that is relevant not only to our material, but relevant to the 90s. It's okay to feel, it's okay to be colorful.
Done. Can we do this?
Yeah, check her out.
Okay, fine, then this one's for her.
Okay. I can't face another night on my own.
I give up my pride. All right, still 1-2.
We're really dedicated to doing a video. And we had an idea. Gunnar actually came to me and said he had this wacky dream with an Indian in it, an Indian chief who took him through a vision quest.
And he holds up these two balls of light. One is blue, one is red.
So the blue is the spiritual side of humanity. The red is the aggressive and sexual side.
He holds out a feather.
It symbolizes the fruition of a journey. It was kind of strange. We were on the set doing that bedroom scene with Rick, who played the kid, and he said, "What do you want the father to say to him right now? You've got to tell me something that will make him cry." And it just came out of me, and I said, "You will never amount to anything. You're nothing but a worthless dreamer." And those were direct quotes that I had been told throughout my childhood, and I started crying when he was doing it because it was so real to me.
No matter what problems were going on at home,
that we had two constants. And right. That was we had each other, and we had our music.
You know, he doesn't do nothing anymore. Sits in that room, listens to the tapes, which I buy him.